I've always had an interest in really purist lines and purist shapes, but a lot of surface decoration. So when somebody calls me a maximalist, I almost take offense, because I'm a maximalist in terms of my textiles and my developments, but I'm a purist in terms of the lines. A damask, a rose, a paisley, all that is repeat motifs that you see worn, adorned in homes, in fashion, in anything. And I think for me, the play on it was to look at how you put those together and what do they mean when they're juxtaposed with a different surface.
It was such a clash, you know, that kind of 19th century Victorian, you know, kind of swirls and velvet, and then with this very kind of techie, almost plastic video game world. She's at a point where she has the kind of fan base that will go wherever she wants to go, and I think they will really go there with her.
I think Mary's an incredible talent. I think she's really brought back creativity in a very elegant and chic way. I think what for me stands out is just the quality and the craftsmanship. I mean, the clothes are almost couture, but they're incredibly wearable and they're really fresh. I think that women look gorgeous in her clothes. I think she celebrates femininity. Not a conventional femininity, perhaps, but one that I think is really beautiful. It's very brave, and I think Mary just continues to prove that she's original and she's ahead of the pack.
She's always so surprising. It was like we were thrown into a future era where the new Satin Duchesse is plastic. She made it chic and wearable.
She really knows what women want to wear, and the fact that it was technical but so wearable, I think it was a great show. Colors, everything. I love her.
Usually per season I have a very thematic collection that usually revolves around the artwork. And this time it wasn't about that, it was about different elements coming together.